Hello students, today we are going to start with a new poem, The Little White Dog, written by May Ellis Nichols. Let's know a few things about May Ellis Nichols before we understand the poem. She was an American poet who was born in 1862. She has written a number of poems for children. I shall read the poem for you and simultaneously explain what the poet wants to deliver to us. The Little White Dog. The little white dog with the meek brown eyes, tell me the boon that you most prize. Would a juicy bone meet your heart's desire, or a cozy rug by blazing fire, or a sudden race with truant cat, or a gentle word, or a friendly pat? If possible, I would like you to keep page 26 of book A ready so that you can look at the picture on the page. Even if not, let me tell you that there is a lady, a dog, and a boy standing on the footpath. They all are on the same side of the road. The lady in the picture wants to know what the little white dog wants most of all. She describes it as a dog with meek brown eyes. Here the word meek means gentle or mild. So the lady says that the little white dog has gentle eyes. She asks him what would be the dog's wish, which would give the best prize. She gives a variety of choices. She asks him if a juicy bone would make him happy, or if a cozy rug by a very hot fire would make him happy, if a sudden race with a truant cat make him happy, if a gentle word or a friendly pat makes him happy. These are the choices lady gives to dog. Is that ball you have always near the dearest of all the things held dear? Or is the home you left behind the dream of bliss to your doggish mind? But the little white dog just shook his head, as if none of these are best, he said. The second stanza, the lady gives some more choices, like, would it be the ball which he always has near him, the best of all? Or the home he left behind, the reason for happiness to his doggish mind? The lady says that the little white dog just shook his head, as if none of the above choices are the best for him. In this way, the lady gave a few options to the dog. A boy's clear whistle comes from the street. There is a wag of the tail and twinkle of feet. And the little white dog did not even say, "Excuse me, ma'am," as he scampered away. But I am sure, as can be, his greatest joy is just to trot behind that little boy. And then, let me tell you what happened. While the lady was giving choices to the little white dog, the dog heard a clear whistle from the street. Guess what the dog would have done? It wagged its tail and moved its feet, said, "Excuse me, ma'am," and scampered away. What is scampered away? Scampered away means run very fast. The lady then was sure that the greatest joy for the dog was just to trot behind the little boy. Trot means walk by skipping on diagonal pairs of legs. I repeat, it means walk by skipping on diagonal pairs of legs. Was not the poem very interesting, students? I want each one of you to read the poem in a rhythmic way and learn the new vocabulary. There are certainly a lot of new vocabulary for you to learn and use them in your daily life. Thank you and take care.